Next up, we have Yavin from LinkedIn to talk about mocking the internet.
Hello, everyone. I know it's about time for lunch, but let me use the 10 minutes to give you something more interesting and may help in your day-to-day work. So a little bit about myself. My name is Yabin Kang. I'm from LinkedIn New York team. I have been with LinkedIn for 3 years. So today I'm going to talk about the topic mock the internet, which I will first introduce the new mocking system that we are currently working on, which is called flashback, and also give you the overview of the mocking strategy that we have in LinkedIn. So flashback is a network layer mocking system that taking care of all the outbound traffic that goes on the internet, where you really don't want to see like the third-party downtime network issue or resource constraints that break your test. That's why we create flashback. Before we jump into the details, let's talk a little bit about like why we like mocking, not only for unit tests, but also for the service level integration test. So why mocking? Imagine we have the LinkedIn profile page. Hopefully everyone in this room has a LinkedIn profile. Otherwise, you miss a chance to connect the other 400 million professionals. This is truly my advice, not the marketing team asked me to do. Okay, back to the profile page. So it requires more than 100 downstream dependency services to render this page. If you're a test, and most likely your test, you just test one tiny specific change on this page, you don't really want to rely on all these dependencies, right? And things are getting worse if one of the dependencies is actually an external service that on the internet, which you don't have the control. So the best way to solve this problem is mock them, mock all the dependencies. Then you have a good test. So taking a look at this high-level picture of LinkedIn ingestion service. By the way, ingestion service is built by our New York team. And it is a service to grab the content from internet to enrich your profile to be more attractive. So besides the typical three-tier architecture on the left, you will see there is a gateway service in the middle. It is it's working as a proxy. And here is a good opportunity for us to mock in this layer in order to test our ingestion service without relying on the external providers. And this is where the flashback fits in. So flashback still acts as a proxy, handles the HTTP, HTTPS traffic, intercept the requests and response, and store them. It is controlled by test framework, so you can start it like record or replay. You can also change the mock data on the fly from your test case, since we have the API. Or as you wish, you can manipulate the response in a way to test the different variation of the negative case for your service. So basically, you have the full control of what's going to be mocked on the network. So let me show you some code. This is an implementation about the record and play inside flashback. When we recording, we actually take the response returned from the external provider and pairing it with the request that came from the internal service and store them locally. When replaying, we load the local stored response according to the request that came from the internal service and just return them back. So there's not going to be anything, any traffic goes on the internet. Also, I want to show you guys some the mock data, the actual mock data. You can see we have all the information about the request and response. And like I mentioned, you can actually manipulate the response by modifying this file. Like we can change the status code to something else, from 200 to 404 to indicate a not found response. Or you can modify the content of the HTTP body to something else, anything you want. Then in this way, you can test your service in a lot more scenarios than you can see how strong, how reliable your service is. So Okay, flashback is a good solution for us to test in our ingestion service without relying on the external provider. But when we step back and take a look at the whole picture of how flashback works, it's actually, it seems a common solution, just doing the mocking, the network, the traffic, right? If we can make the flashback more generic to be a centralized service or system, it can help in a lot of other places in the same manner, like the internal service. So LinkedIn internal service are all REST files, which means you have a common library being used by the service and all the clients. So to adding the support for flashback is just like a config change to a flashback-enabled HTTP client, then you can use that. It's quite easy, and nothing needs to be changed inside your service. It's also a good solution for data service. As long as your service is going through HTTP protocol, then you can enable flashback, and it will take care of the mocking part, mocking the data from your data service. Also, it's more interesting to talk about the mobile client testing. So when we do mobile client testing, we actually need to launch the emulator, launch the app, and deploy your service, and having the real traffic between the client and your service. But instead of making all this left traffic, if we can set up the proxy inside the emulator and point to the flashback, and then you can take advantage of the flashback and the proxy of mocking, network mocking. So it's quite easy to set up the proxy inside the emulator. And also, it also works for a real device. And again, there is nothing need to be changed inside your app. You can just use flashback. I hope you guys have the idea of what we are trying to build. The flashback, it helps you in the area of doing the service level integration test that requires a network layer mocking. And we are trying to build it in a way that could be open sourced, and it will be leveraged by anyone who wants to use, or anyone who even want to make contribution back. Or you can like come and join us in LinkedIn, and let's work together and mock and roll. Thank you.
Thank you. What's the difference between using dedicated flashback service versus using mocking frameworks at the class layer, like Mockito, EasyMock, et cetera?
So the flashback is still like network layer mocking. So for those unit test mocking is kind of mock the class layer. So when we mock the network layer, so you actually have the real traffic goes out to goes out from your service, so that's verified like a lot more than like just inside the class.
How does flashback compare to WireMock or other mock proxy tools?
That's a good question. I know someone will ask this question. So WireMock is flashback was the idea for flashback was for our ingestion service. We build that as a proxy. Then we realize we actually there is like WireMock or Betamax. There are a lot of other mocking network mocking stuff there, but some of them is now doing like a proxy way. Some of them is not handle like the HTTPS traffic. So we end up with we want to build something ourselves.
How do you deal with post requests, and how do you deal with URL GET with variable parameters like timestamp, random session ID, etc.?
The post request, I think, is the same. Like, it's still just a request. It's just different method. So we have the post, like in the mock data, we have the method tab for GET or post. To deal with the different parameter like timestamp, random session. Okay, so. So this problem is we don't have this problem for our ingestion service testing because we most of our case is like a static content, static URL and content, but we do have thought about this. We can make some parameter or variables inside your URL, or you have a way to indicate, okay, this part of data is like dynamic, we don't care. We just care something like the important is a get, and what's the URL, what's the body, the content, yeah.
Is flashback open source?
Yes, it's gonna be open source, yeah.
That one's a repeat. How do you manage situations where third-party providers change their layout or schema?
Okay, that's another good question. So basically, so for the case for our ingestion service, we don't have the idea when the third party will change their content, right? So we keep running our test for using the mock data, which making sure our service is still working for at least the old data. Then we have some live tests to making sure that's gonna be working for the new data. And also, since you have the mock data, you can periodically check the data versus the new data from the third party. Then you will know, like, is there any change? Is there any schema change or some content change? If there's a significant change, you can re-record the stuff and doing the test again.
How does it handle HTTPS requests?
Okay, so since you know we are using like the proxy way, handle HTTPS request, we have to have a man-in-the-middle proxy. So we kind of implement that, and that's the most challenging in flashback. Since most of our URL is going through HTTPS traffic, so we spend a lot of time on like handling the HTTPS and doing the man in the middle thing. Yeah.
How do you keep recorded data up to date?
That's sort of like if the content changes on the third party. So, like I said, for whatever the mock data you have, you should be able to test to run your test. But if the data changed, you need to have a mechanism to check if there's anything changed between your old data and the new data from the third party. So, so like I said, you need to periodically check this thing.
How do you ensure mocked tests don't get forgotten about when internal services APIs changed?
Okay, that's sort of similar to the last question, but I think it's more like asking about the internal service. Since we testing, if we're running that against internal service, so you have the idea what version you are using for your downstream service. So basically, you have a service, you have a version for your own service, and you have another dependency service. So when you update your dependency service, you know something might be changed, right? So in the flashback, either you do re-recording every time there is a change for the downstream version, or we want to have some like mechanism to say my test knows my service, and we know we only care about some particular data. Like I only care about the first name, last name. I don't care about like maybe someday that there is a new field that says title or something. So I can have a way to verify like if the new service, if I construct the data schema for the new service still have the first name, last name, then it's good. I can still use that data. I can still test my service, and it should not break my service, should not break my test, and there is nothing I should worry about for the downstream update.
And one last question. They keep moving. Where's the new one? How is Flashback different than LinkedIn's other product, Cephea?
So the flashback start with like I mentioned for the ingestion service, the proxy, all the our other products is kind of doing either the mocking inside the service or inside the class, which is you need you have to modify something inside your service or inside your code, which this kind of give you the benefit of like proxy. As long as you can set up a proxy, then you're good to go.
Great, thank you very much.
Thank you, guys.